delayed happy greetings. Today, according to the wisdom of Bhagavad Gita, we will discuss this. I wrote it here. The food and the body and the mind, they are all connected. We know it, but what Bhagavad Gita says, that is what we are going to discuss. And Bhagavad Gita's wisdom, it is time-tested. Many thousand years, lot of brilliant minds came into this planet. They tested this and nobody made any change in the philosophical analysis of body, mind and food. Food, you know, we are not aware, but food is the fuel to your body. But that is not enough. That is not the right definition. Food is of three types. Rice, sattvic, I said that, S-R-T, sattvic, rajasic, and tamasic. Three types of food. Sattvic food, because anything which you eat, you start thinking that way. So your eating habits is directly proportionate to your thinking habits. So let us say if you take 2 pegs of whiskey, you will never talk spirituality. You will talk something else. But if I give you a glass of milk and the situation where you are taking that milk, it is very serene, peaceful, immediately your mind will be conducive to go back to your original line of thinking, which is spirituality, good things, you will talk good things. So, whatever we eat, it affects our body first of all, because it has to be processed through our body. We treat body as a dumping bin. We put everything without realizing what I am doing. And the wisdom of Bhagavad Gita is in chapter 15. I shared with you before also that in chapter 15 Lord Krishna says, Sarvasya chaham haridisanni vishto mattaha samritir jnanam pohanam cha vedai cha sarvai rahameva vedyo vedant kridade avidheva chaham. So this is called the spiritual warranty. When you buy a product, they give you the warranty, right there. This is a spiritual warranty for all the human beings. Lord Krishna says, the meaning of this particular verse is, it is in 4 parts. One is, he says that I am seated in the heart of everybody. So, with that presumption, if he is seated in the heart of everybody, then what is your body? I'm just asking. It's a temple. Right? So, it is a very strong awareness that my body is a temple. Lord Krishna is seated here. But I have to profoundly convince myself that it is like that. If I just hear and let it go, this thought, then I will not change. But I will change, because it's a revolutionary idea that my body is a temple. So if my body is a temple, I should behave like a temple. I should behave like, behaving like temple means do the divine things. So Lord Krishna is seated in the heart of everybody. So our bodies are temple. Second part is that I am the memory, he says. The memory part in our body, it is Lord Krishna. So use your memory judiciously. What we do, we are deleting the goodness of people and we are saving the bad things of people. You did something to me one day. which was not, it may be a bad day, but you did it, I immediately save it. But you did 20 years, you did a lot of good things to me, and you have been doing that. You are my best friend. I immediately delete that on that day. So what I did, I misused and abused the memory. I should have taken a break that it may be a bad day for me or for you. Because for 20 years you didn't do this. And only today you said something which was not expected of you. So I should not save this. Let it go. It may be one time event. And I should continue to save your goodness of 20 years, and this today's event should be deleted right away. But we are doing the other way around, on a daily basis. And when we do that, the mind becomes agitated, excited. You don't sleep, because how come he said that? How come he said that? I never expected from him. And I continue to repeat to myself, and I lose my speech. When you lose your speech, if you are not sleeping properly, your immune system is compromised. The other diseases which are waiting to enter in your body, they get the permission. You will get cold, you will get allergy, you will get other thing. But who did that? Me. You. You had the freedom, the choice, not to do that. So Lord Krishna says, I am the memory. So delete the shortcomings of others, brother, wife, sister, son, daughter, friends. Delete. It's not worth. Your mind is very precious. Use it like the safety box. You have the safety box in the bank, right? You don't put this junk there. All the precious things you are keeping, jewelry, documents, other things which are extremely important to you in your life. So, mind is exactly like that. It's a safety box. Save those things which are precious. Save the wisdom of Bhagavad Gita. It's precious. It is timeless. It is, you cannot put a price on this particular thought process. So save that. But we are not doing that, and we pay heavy price. We suffer. Life is easy, we make it difficult. Life is pleasure, but we suffer. Life is a escapee. Life is to enjoy it. But due to our misunderstanding and ignorance of the reality around us, we suffer. We suffer and we make others suffer who are around us. So if I am agitated, excited, I give hard time to my wife, to my kids. If I am the boss, I will give hard time to my associate, to my employees, to whom I supervise. So it is a contagious circle, slippery road. Who can stop it? I have to stop it. So Bhagavad Gita's wisdom is the science of responsibility. I have to be responsible for my actions. I cannot blame you. I cannot blame the society. I cannot blame my parents. I have the choice. So I have to make the choice. Whenever the situation comes, make a right choice. When in this whole planet where we live, there are two types of forces, visible, invisible. Visible forces are which you see through your naked eye and you through other five senses, perceptions, right? Touch, smell, sight, hearing, taste. Those are also bring you the information. So you have so many avenues to collect the information. But that information, which is the visible part, it is only 1%. Can you believe that? 99%, it is invisible. 99% invisible. And in that invisible forces, there are two types of forces. Evil forces and divine forces. So when you do some divine work, selfless work, charitable work, divine forces help you. And when you do bad things, evil forces help you. And the example is, a petty thief, after 2 years, if he's not caught, he becomes professional. And vice versa too. You take swimming lesson, after 2 years of taking proper lesson and practicing, you are a professional swimmer. So whatever we do and do the practice, we become that. We become that. Because the invisible forces which I shared with you, divine and evil, they help you. If you do divine things, divine forces help you. Because that brings you the determination that I should continue to do that. Because the thief will say, I am not caught. He may be a petty thief in Macy's store shoplifting. But if he is not caught, if he beat the security system, cameras, and security officers and everything else, he gets the encouragement from the evil forces that, no, go ahead, do it. And after 2 years, he's a professional. So, this is the awareness. This is the awareness that I have to do divine things so that I should get, I should tap those resources. These are the energies, energies. All like they say that in Hinduism we worship many gods. They don't understand that. Those are the names of the energies. Like there's an energy you call electricity. There's an energy you call fire. There's an energy you call kinetic energy. There's a gravitational force. These are all energies. So in English, you give different names. What is wrong in spirituality if the Hindu thought, the Eastern thought, bring this notion? Because the idea is to respect them. Like they say, Jal Devta. Right? Now the whole world, the topmost priority of the world is don't contaminate the atmosphere. Don't pollute it. It could be air, it could be water, right? This is the main thrust these days. And Bhagavad Gita and the Eastern philosophy, from the rooftop, they have been telling the whole world, don't do that. So they said Jal Devta, Vayu Devta, Agni Devta, Anna Devta, and they called the earth Mata. So this is the concept, because these are the names of the energies, and you have to worship the energies. Like you, with the cooking gas, you can cook a nice food, but you can burn the house also. If you leave it unattended, it will burn. So who has to control it? Me, you. So judiciously we have to select our choices, make right decisions at right time, then these divine forces and evil forces, both, will give you the boost. So I should be aware when I initiate any action, any thought, because first of all it is the thought, then it is the action, then it is the practice. Any action which is done consistently on a regular basis for 6 months, it is your habit. It is your reflex. It is your reflex. So before anything becomes habit, before you practice anything, be aware, is it good or bad? Am I doing the right practice? Because right practice will make you right person, and wrong practice will take you in the wrong side. Choice is yours. So Bhagavad Gita gives you the wisdom, the awareness, that you are the master of your destiny. We blame destiny in many ways. Whenever work is not done in a way which we expect, हम कहते हैं हिंदी में कहते हैं ओ ये मेरी डेस्टिनी में था. नो, यू आर द मास्टर ऑफ योर डेस्टिनी. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल अडॉप्ट द राइट मीन्स, राइट इंटेंशंस, राइट प्रोसेस, राइट प्रोसीजर, एंड देन इफ इट डज नॉट अचीव द रिजल्ट देन यू कैन से इट मे बी इन माई डेस्टिनी. बट इफ आई डोंट डू एनीथिंग and sitting on a chair and I say, last time I did that, it didn't work, so it my destiny is like that. No. In spirituality there is no inertia. Bhagavad Gita is action. It, wherever there is an action, Bhagavad Gita is there. It makes you active, positive. If you are negative, you are not a spiritual person. The litmus test of spirituality is you've got to be 100% positive and make people positive. Uplift them. Uplift them in whatever way. Through charity, through your thoughts, through your physical health. Change people, help people, selflessly. And that is the objective of life. Make this creation more beautiful before we leave. Don't destroy it. Don't contaminate it. Don't pollute it. So, we were talking about the food, and then this issue came up. So, food is of three types. Eat fresh food. There's another verse in Bhagavad Gita. Yukta har viharasya yukta cheshtasya karmasu युक्त स्वप्न बोधस्य योगो भवति दुःखः. ईट बैलेंस्ड डाइट. डोंट ईट टू लिटल, डोंट ईट टू मच. इफ यू वांट टू कीप द डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम एट इट्स ऑप्टिमम लेवल एंड स्टे हेल्दी, यू गॉट टू बी वेरी केयरफुल हाउ मच टू ईट, हाउ मच नॉट टू ईट. सो बैलेंस, बैलेंस. And then sleeping. I told you, people who are deprived of sleep, they invite many diseases silently. Silently. Diseases are right under your pillow. Once you leave this you are deprived of this sleep, they seep into your system. So, sleep. You can sleep only when your mind is not agitated, when you are not excited. So watch, because night will come. Night will come, night has to come, right? So watch it during the day, what I do, will it keep my mind at peace or agitated or excited? So when you are selfless, when you are selflessly doing certain things, your mind is at peace. When you are selfish, your mind is agitated, excited, does not matter what you do. So be very, very, this is a spiritual caveat, that don't do these things. Because the night will come, then you will have to pay the price, you will not sleep. You will not, your thoughts will not let you sleep. But who is doing that? I am doing that. I can control. You cannot do anything for me. I have to do myself. So, sleep, they say 6 to 7 hours. That should be a healthy sleep. But that does not mean I should sleep 10 hours. And it should not be 5 hours. So I should practice. Practice. We are the product of practice. Abhyas. Of sleeping at least 7 hours if we want to be healthy. But that will, your sleep is associated to your food also, what type of food you eat. But everything becomes metabolism and it seeps into the bloodstream. And the end result is, if I eat right food, sattvic food, fruits, don't eat meat. Don't eat. You have the choice. I am not saying vegetarian, non-vegetarian. Everybody is intelligent these days. But I am sharing with you sattvic food. If you want to have a good sleep, if you want to have a good health, if you have to keep a good memory, because as you grow, people have lot of, they lose the memory, right? Dementia. They suffer because they misuse and abuse the memory. You know, Lord Krishna is not living there in their memory. That's why they suffer. But Lord Krishna says, I am the memory. So if I use judiciously, don't misuse and abuse the memory, then you will be all right. And you don't need any doctor, you don't need any lab, you don't need any medical treatment, you don't need any extra medicine. It is only through your thoughts. Through your thoughts, you can change the whole thing. So if we eat sattvic food, we will have better sleep, we will have better digestive system. In one of the verses, Lord Krishna says that in your body, in the human body, I am the digestive system. And I take care of everything. When whatever you put inside, I take care of it. It is a thought. It's an idea that Lord Krishna is the digestive system. So if Lord Krishna is sitting here, what type of work you will assign to him? To clean the floor? No. You will give him the best. So you don't want to abuse his powers. You don't want to give him discomfort. So that is the same idea. Extend the same idea. If Lord Krishna is the digestive system, put something better. Put something better. Then he will help you. You will never be sick. Your digestive system will be working at optimum level. And the result is, we are healthy. We are healthy. These days, there are building after building after building. People are sick. And you go enter in that building, thousands of people are walking around in those buildings, in those corridors, suffering. It was not like that. It was not like that. So from where all these diseases, all these ailments popped in? No, it we created it. Through, because we are not disciplined in our eating habits, in our thinking habits, in our interaction with people, we think bad of others. So how can I be a healthy person? I cannot be a healthy person. So Bhagavad Gita's wisdom is, through food, we are just talking one element, through food you can eliminate many of these shortcomings in our personality. So eat right, sattvic food. Don't eat the other one, rajasic and tamasic. Rajasic food is the non-vegetarian food. That will change your thinking differently. Deep down you will be violent. Violence is of three types. Physical violence. Right? And then there is a violence through your thoughts. You are thinking bad things about others. That is also a violence. You lose your confidence and you think bad things about yourself. That is also a violence. So, but if you are eating sattvic food, this system will not trigger. You will stay calm, quiet, peaceful, tall. You will meet and deal with people and change them, make them positive. And by doing that, in that process, you are maturing your own personality. You will shine more because you are doing the best thing. We will go into office. In your office, in your cubicle, people will come. They will love to come to you. If they see you in the elevator, they will say 1,000 times, good morning, not one time. Because you, they know it. It reflects from your face. So, try to earn the goodwill on a daily basis. I am just talking about the food. I will talk the other things later on. Try to earn the goodwill of people on a daily basis. An example I will share with you. That you are in the elevator. The elevator is full. Full. And you are late. And it's a multi-story building. The elevator come back after maybe 5-6 minutes. You are already late 10 minutes. So you are in a hurry to enter. And there is only one seat. One person can go in. But there is another person waiting also. So now, what type of decision you will make? Chances are 99% people will step in. They will say, hell with it, I am already late 15 minutes late. But if you understand that this is a golden opportunity to earn the goodwill, you will say, sir, go ahead. Right? Because you are already ready, it's only no matter of 5 minutes. When that guy enters into the elevator, what he will think about you? Just think. He will say certain things to himself, right? When he will sit in his cubicle, and how many times he will talk about you? He will tell everybody to whomsoever he interacts. Aaj main late ho raha tha. The guy said, go ahead. So he will continue to talk. So if I didn't do that, I didn't harm him. But my objective is that on a daily basis, I have to earn goodwill. I am driving. I have the right of way. There is a crossing. I have the right of way. But I let you go. What do you think about me? And right, the windows are closed, you will wave me, right? Because you cannot talk to me. But when you will, wherever you are going, chances are, you may be acting the same way, because I affected you. You may be giving right of way to others also. This is how the goodwill is earned. Goodwill is earned. We go to temples. I'm just giving examples to make this point very clear. Earn goodness and goodwill on a daily basis. That will change you. In that process, you are making the creation better at your own level. We are not the prime minister. We are not the aristocrat. But at a minimal, small steps, that is what the life is. In a temple we go, after the puja is over, there is a food. How people behave there? People who come late, they are in the first of the line to get the food. Right? Right? And they were listening the beautiful sermons. They forgot everything. Right? So suppose I am also standing in the line. Right? And you are behind me. And there is a long line. So I stepped and I said, please go ahead. I am still standing there. You are just one step ahead of me. What you will think of me? You will not get the food by doing my this action. But what you will think? You will think positive about me. This is how the goodwill can be earned. Goodwill. And it is free. You are not paying anybody to buy this thing. Cost effective. free. So that is what the whole spirituality is. Change can make the people change. But change has to initiate from you. Until you change, there is no change. Change has to come from me. When I am changed, I will change you. But because I have experience now. I have perfected this art to earn the goodwill of people. When you will interact with me for a couple of days, you will start doing the same thing. That Mr. Kapoor does that, you know, he is alright. Why? What is wrong with me? So, but it depends what type of food I am eating. Otherwise, it will not happen. Otherwise, the mind is excited, agitated, in a selfish mode. There are three types of mind, modes of mind. Selfish, selflessness, a neutral zone. But when your food is not controlled, when your food is not sattvic, chances are your actions are selfish. Your thoughts are selfish. You are doing, everybody is going to office, but you are doing, my way of eating is sattvic and your way of eating is not sattvic and we are sitting together, you are thinking something else. I will be thinking something else. My actions on a daily basis will be more qualitative, more humane, more lovable, more empathetic, more helpful. The person who is not taking care of the food will be selfish, will be hurting people, he will enjoy gossip. So this is how the food affects. So eat sattvic food. Then the sattvic thoughts will originate. So now the second part, we talked enough of food. Second is the body. When the food goes into the body, right? I wrote two words. There are two types of bodies. One is the outside, which you look at it in front of the mirror. One is inside. Outside body. Now people are doing yoga. Some parents are there. What they are doing? They are taking care of the outer body. And what you are doing here, you are taking care of the inside. I am everything, my whole presentation is sharing with you to talk and polish your inside. I am not touching your body. I am not making any. I can do all that. But that is the outer frame. So I must understand that there are two bodies. Outer body, which you can bring into good shape through asanas, different postures, you know. And there are a lot of good asanas. But that is the outside. And people stop there. So it is like this. If a person, because the term yoga has been being abused these days. Every gym has become a yoga center. Our rishis, munis, they had no idea that the world will start doing this and they charge so much money. They never charged anything. I am talking to you, this spirituality is free. People are charging thousands of dollars. They make CDs. Another program, they give you internet. If you Google this, it's a big market. Billions of dollars of market selling spirituality and yoga. Yoga world has been misused. Everybody is saying I'm doing yoga. But if your body is strong, very strong, right? And you say I'm doing yoga, what happens? The result is your ego is very strong. Because inner you didn't take care of that. It's a combination. take care of the outer body, but take care of the inside also. Otherwise, it is a fodder, it's a food, fuel to your ego. You will be gossiping, bragging that I do a lot of yoga. The outer frame will look all right, but inside, you may not be sleeping. Because yet there your mind, you need a peace of mind. The outer body will not extend that facility to you. So yoga is good, but it should be in the combination. So according to the inventor of this philosophy, Rishi Patanjali, his name was Patanjali, P-A-N-A-T-A-N-J-L-I. He initiated eight steps. The first five steps for the men to make the outer frame befitting tool to go inside. The last three steps is to polish the mind. So there are three steps. What I am talking to you, this food thing, once the food is properly digested, there is no gas, you are not taking any medicine, you know. You eat, you digest, your mind is calm. Your thoughts are different, qualitative. And I just shared with you that first of all it is the thought, and then it is the action, and then it is the practice. And when I do that practice for a longer period of time, that is my habit. And the collection of habits is my personality. And at the top of that, if I maintain that personality consciously, helping others, that becomes my character. Character means you will never compromise. It's okay. Let him enjoy. He is also doing meditation. So, we compromise many things. So, I am just initiating an idea just to get the input. Suppose there is $1 million. I gave the example before also. You are going, you are walking, morning walk, in a wooded area. So then you find there is $1 million lying there. Right? Now, what we will do? Now it's a decision. Right? So, one thought process is that pick it up. Nobody is seeing. Right? And I am not stealing anybody. It is just lying there. I don't know how long. Maybe 2 years, 10 years. And this is a golden opportunity. I worked so hard. I worked 8 hours. I earned, let us say, $200,000. But this is $1 million. And that will, you will plan mentally. And chances are 99% people will pick it up. With lifetime opportunity. And nobody is seeing, that is guaranteed. Nobody has seen you. And nobody will see you after that picking also. That is a condition. But my question is, we will pick it up. But if through the wisdom of Bhagavad Gita, I practice right from today, the thing which is not mine, I will not take. Whether it is a pencil, a rubber, $1 million, ton, $10 million, $1 billion. If it is not mine, I will not take it. So the chances are, if I have practiced that thought, I will just look at it and will think that it is a bunch of leaves. I will not put the value. I will treat it as a stone. Because thing becomes valuable when you put the value. If you don't understand the difference between the stone and the diamond, right, then everything is stone. But once you put the, through your intellect, through your knowledge, if you put the value, that this is the diamond, now you put the value, it becomes a lot of money. So, when we practice of certain things, practice the right thing. And this is the right thing. The thing which is not mine, I should not take it. Then the divine forces will help you. One day, you will get the opportunity to be the rich. Through your only this thinking. Through thinking. So, we should not compromise on a daily basis small things. And try to earn the goodness of others, I explained to you. But this will happen only through food. Food. And now we were talking of the body. Outer body, you have to take care. You have to take care. Because Lord Krishna is seated here. You have to take care of it. You have to exercise. You have to do your yogic postures. Right? Five steps are there. But don't forget the three other steps. And in that process comes the meditation. Meditation is not yoga. Meditation is the science of mind. How to polish the mind? How to make it peaceful? It is cost effective. It is doable. It has been done. It is your commodity. Everybody has it. But we don't have the awareness and we don't know the process, how to tap the resources to make the mind at peace. All these people, I tell you, if you read their biographies, even Bill Gates, the richest man, if you read, they have that ability. Their decisions were taken when the mind was at still. They can, when you have you gone to these lakes, when the water is still, you see yourself. And when the water is in a turmoil, lot of air is roaming around, you know, then the water is muddy and you can't see yourself. So this is how what happens when the mind is at peace. You are at your original state, and your clarity of decision is very clear, beneficial to you and to the society. They became rich not through becoming a don. They created programs, they hired brilliant people, they helped them to make rich. They made, in the process, everybody became millionaire. Googles have thousands and thousands of employees, and they are all millionaires. But there are so many benefits. So, mind has to be at peace. If your mind is agitated, your relationship is spoiled. You will be angry, angry man, just looking for the outlet. If you are angry or I am angry, I am holding it, even like he was making a noise, right? I don't know if we were not here, only dad and he, that little child was there. I don't know what he will tell him, because we are all here, that may be a little control. But he may not be an angry man. So his interaction with the child will be different. So this is how it works. So if I am at peace, I will make you peaceful. But it will happen only through mind. I will not touch you. I will not do anything to you. But I will make you peaceful. Now, people who practice the art of making the mind at peace, they make people peaceful. It is contagious. It is like a smile. Smile is contagious. Peace is contagious. Peace is contagious. So, we are time is over.
I think we have like.
So then we will stop right here. We will continue, and we will talk about the body and meditation. We will do meditation. I will show you. I will demonstrate to you next time. Which is the best meditation to control the mind, to bring the concentration, to polish the focus, which you need in your job and in every walk of life. Most of the time we are not like that, but meditation at no cost, free, will make you a different person. Next time we will practically do the meditation, and we'll talk about the meditation, and then we'll go to the mind. We will wrap it up and go to some other concept. Thank you very much. Jai Shri Krishna.
Jai Shri Krishna.